Summer's almost here, which means more of you will be hitting the water.
Florida Fish and Wildlife says responsible boating is important not just to keep you safe, but our wildlife as well. NBC2's Ryan Arbogast is in Collier County on the water tonight.
It's time to cast off on Marco Island, and NBC2 News is taking you aboard. We're riding along with the Florida Fish and Wildlife Commission as they enforce boat safety measures in southern Collier County ahead of Memorial Day.
We have a lot of rental boats going out, and you know there may be some a lack of education out here.
Captain Randy Yanez is the Collier County commander for FWC. He tells us there were 20 accidents on these waters in our neck of the woods last year. Just take a look at these images. 19 people were injured and one died. Plus, in March, a man and woman also died in a crash into the mangroves in Little Hickory Bay.
Our leading cause of fatalities on the water are either due to life jackets, not maintaining a proper lookout, or boating under the influence. And in my opinion, all those things can be controlled.
FWC says about 25% of boat accidents are related to drugs or alcohol, and a number of others are due to outdated safety or missing equipment. So we're stopping boats here on Marco Island to ensure everyone's safe.
We're basically going to check their safety equipment, make sure that they have everything that they need, make sure they're familiar where it's at on their boat.
Our first traffic stop is routine. This couple didn't do anything wrong. Law enforcement just wants to ensure they're traveling safely.
Well, you don't mind if that be your registration ID?
After a couple of minutes, they're good to go. The next isn't as friendly. These twins were caught speeding through a no-wake zone. That's more serious.
We have a zero tolerance policy.
These guys got off with a warning, but FWC says speeding oftentimes coincides with other, much more serious violations. Think BUI. So it's always better to be safe than sorry.
You will go to jail if you're caught boating under the influence.
With the holiday weekend ahead, FWC will be on the water, especially in places that are known to be party hotspots like Key Waden Island.
Challenging that there's going to be a lot more people on the water. So whenever you have more people on the water, you have more potential for accidents.
But law enforcement can't be everywhere. So if you see something, FWC wants you to know, it's crucial to pick up the phone and let them know. Reporting local today off the coast of Marco Island, Ryan Arbogast, NBC2.